Good evening, everybody. So my name is NVS Ramchandra Rao, and I have been working as a manager in small parts of Praga Division, HMT. And I am 22, 25 years experienced on CNC machining centers, whether it be horizontal or vertical. And I have previously worked on quality control and design of a few of the machine tool components also. So before switching over to the part programming on CNC machining centers, we just let us go through the basic operations that are performed in machine tools, which are drilling. For drilling operations, we generally prefer a radial drilling or bench drilling, or based on the size of the component, we will be opting a particular machine. And sometime, and for boring operations, you would have to operate horizontal boring or vertical boring or jig boring machines. And for milling operations, you will be operating a machine, horizontal, vertical, or universal milling machine. Like that, for each different operation, you will have got different types of machines. But if you wanted to do all these operations on a single machine, and that is nothing but CNC machining center. So on CNC machining center, you can just perform drilling operations, tapping, reaming, boring, milling operations. And so for all these, for performing all these operations in a single setup, we just prefer machining center. And those machining centers which are programmed, which are programmable, such machining centers are called CNC machining centers. And for doing programs, for editing programs of CNC machining centers, we will be needing one PMC, programmable machine controller. And these PMCs are, most of the PMCs in this world are FANUC and Cinemaric. So in FANUC, OI-MC model machining PMC is used for CNC machining centers, whether it be horizontal or vertical. And for turning centers, it is OI-TC. TC stands for turning center, MC stands for machining center. So before starting to discuss about programming procedures, we would have to remember a few things, few basic things that we need to maintain. So those are, you assume a cube which will be having six faces. And for every face, there are two adjacent faces. That means three adjacent faces are expected to be at right angles to each other within 0.02 mm or 20 microns if the side of the cube is 300 mm. If at all we could maintain a 20 microns perpendicularity between any two adjacent faces of a cube of size 300 mm, that particular cube can be used in any engineering application in this entire world. It will be that much accurate or precise. It will be, it is a very high precision. Similarly, if there is a cylinder, you have to see that the diameter is not having any taper, and the axis of the runout on the total indicator runout, TIR reading, on at any point on that cylinder held between centers will be within 0.02. And here also, the diameter, here also the diameter is assumed to be 300 mm, and the length also you can assume that it is a 300 mm. In that case, you can just call that as a perfect cylinder, and such a component can be used in any type of engineering industry. Similarly, a sphere. If the sphere, the size of the sphere is within 20 microns, and it's when its diameter is 300 mm, then it can be said that it is very accurate. So these three different shapes and the 20 microns deviation in the right angles or cylindricity or spheroidicity, these are all said to be very highly precise. So while mounting a component on the CNC machining center, we need to align the work face, the surface of the front face of the workpiece, in case of a horizontal machining center, parallel to the x-axis and y-axis. That means the front face of the workpiece is aligned parallel to the xy plane. If such a thing is not done, definitely there will be the variations in the center distances of holes or any machining performed on that face. So let us just come to the topics covered in this slide now. So what is a CNC machine? It is computerized numeric control machine. That means it will be having one monitor and editing keys and keys meant for selecting the edit screen or offset registers, tool offset register, work offset registers, and then selector switches for feed override and spindle override. Like that, there are various controls that are to be operated while performing operations on CNC machining centers. So, and it will be, you can just store around 60 to 80 programs, part programs in the memory. That depends on the capacity of the hard disk present in it. If at all you need to repeatedly load and remove the programs, you can just edit the programs and store them in memory card. And to my knowledge, it is RS-232C, I think. So that can be inserted whenever we need it, and we can just remove it after its application is completed. So, yes, somebody's mic was put on. Just please put it off. And numeric control is a programmable automation in which process is controlled by numbers, letters, and symbols. See, yes. So in numeric code files, NC files, we will be using various symbols or addresses. That is, as we have 26 alphabet, out of 26, the letter E is not used anywhere nowadays, except that all the remaining 25 letters have got various interpretations. And numbers are used for specifying the coordinate values, and plus or minus are used for implying the direction of the position of the coordinate or a line. Okay? And in symbols, regarding symbols, every line will be ending at some point. So after the line has come to an end, a semicolon will be inserted at the end of the line. So semicolon resembles the end of the line in English literature. Whereas in NC blocks, each line of the codes is called NC blocks. That means numeric code block. And in computers, what happens? For every letter, every word, and every sentence, we have to specify an end of the block or end of the file or end of the line like that. Similarly, in numeric code files, each line, as it is called NC block, we have to specify an end of the NC block. Otherwise, the computer misunderstands that and it reads all the lines at a stretch, and the last line, whichever is latest, it will be executed and all the remaining lines will be forgotten by it. So to avoid all such confusions, we have to insert one end of the line by a semicolon. Okay? So the next third line, CNC machining is a process used in the manufacturing sector that involves the use of computers to control machine tools like lathes, mills, and grinders. Of course, nowadays, CNC systems, PMCs, have been in use with various models of machines. Here, it is used in EDM wire cut machines also, machining centers, CNC turning centers, turn mill centers, and several other machines like laser beam cutting, nano jet, and what surface grinders, cylindrical grinders, everywhere. In fact, this CNC system can be used with any machine tool. It is like that. Okay? So, why do we use CNC machines? That is, see, if you start manufacturing one a component, or let us say that you are turning M16 into 2mm pitch stud on a conventional lathe. In that case, you will be making use of one form tool, and you have been considering, you have been given 100 pieces for the manufacture of M16 into 2 studs. In that case, what happens, for every piece, you would have to turn the threads and shoot the gauges, thread ring gauge, to maintain acceptability levels, a good acceptability levels of the manufactured item. So every time you would have to check it, and we cannot be sure of getting identical results in that particular batch itself. Whereas if it is a CNC lathe, once you do the program, check the first component as per the gauge, M16 into 2 thread ring gauge, and once it is suited, automatically everything will be identical, provided there is no wear in the tool. Okay, so for manufacturing components, a batch of the components identically, and for good consistency, reliability, and improving the productivity of the plant, we have to go for CNC machines and CNC lathes or CNC machining centers, or any machine that is that has got a CNC system. 1 minute.
Majilima.
So here what happens, in CNC machines, you will be getting a very good repeatability, high precision, and once you do the program for various operations on a CNC machining center, like drilling, milling, reaming, tapping, and everything, you will be having a different sub-assemblies in the machine, like magazine, tool magazine, work changer, and pallet. See, work changer means which changes the work. There will be, in general, there will be 2 pallets, 2 work tables. On one work table will be on the machine in work area, and the second one will be idle. So these 2 are called pallets or work tables, and there will be one tool magazine which can accommodate 25 tools or 40 tools or 100 tools. That depends on the customer's requirement and the manufacturer's options given by the manufacturer. So let us assume that we are having a machine tool with 40 tools capacity. So there will be 40 tool pockets in which various tools are inserted into them, and each pocket will be having a number like T1, T2, T3, like that up to 40, T40. So, and the tool numbers are allotted by the programmer, and we have to call the tool as and when it is necessary for us by its tool number. Automatically, the PMC will search that particular tool, bring the tool and insert into the spindle, and we will be using it for machining. As soon as the machining is completed, again we will give a command to return it back to its original place in the tool magazine, and that will be taken away from the spindle and inserted into the its location. Okay, 1 minute please. So, assuming that we are not having any problem with the machine, the tool change will be taken automatically. Once we give a complete full-fledged program, you can just prove it for the first workpiece, and once it is, once the program is proved, you will be idle. You will be just taking the measurements of whatever machining we have done on the workpiece and confirm that it is in acceptable condition. If there is any deviation, then we will do the necessary adjustments in the cutting tool or workpiece or whatever we have got to do. Automatically, the once the first work piece, first piece of the work is proved to be in acceptable limits, then we will go ahead with the entire batch. Without disturbing it, you can complete it. Another thing is, see, in the global, to survive in the global CA market, CA's machines are a must to achieve closer tolerances. Yes, of course. Assume, see here, in even in your examinations, you will be assuming a few things based on which you will be going ahead to derive a formula or prove whatever has been asked in the question paper. Similarly, here, we are assuming that the machine is not having any problem and the cutting tool is good, in good condition. There are no power failures or power flickering. And the operator is good at operating the machine and the programmer does not commit any mistake. Like that, a few assumptions are made. But in practice, definitely we will come across a few problems and we have to compensate them while doing the program and appointing an operator on the machine and take care of the instruments, workpiece, tools and everything. Okay, so let us go to the next slide. See, as regards to the fundamentals of CNC programming, we need to first understand what are the various coordinate systems that we generally come across. And the basic coordinate system is Cartesian coordinate system. And in this, you will be having three axes, X, Y, and Z. And in machines, the machines will be of various sizes, small machines, medium-sized machines, and very heavy machines, which will be around 3 to 4 stories. That means 60 feet, 100 feet machines also are there. So for such machines, for heavy machines, there will be extensions in x-axis and y-axis and z-axis. So if at all any extension is provided in such machines, the extension provided along x-axis is called U. If an extension is provided along y-axis, parallel to the y-axis, that is V. And the extension in z-axis is called W. That means you will be having X, Y, Z, U, V, W. Okay? Totally, you will be having 6 different axes here. And you will be coming across rotary tables which can rotate, which can be rotated or indexed about x-axis, about y-axis, and about z-axis also. So if a rotary table is provided such that it rotates about x-axis, it is called a-axis. If a rotary table is provided which can rotate about y-axis, then it is called b. If a rotary table which can rotate on z-axis is provided, then it is called C. So A, B, C represent the rotary tables which can rotate about X, Y, and Z. And extensions of X, Y, Z axis are represented by U, V, and W. Just go through the slide. And just if you have any doubts, you can just put on your microphone and directly talk to me. I shall clarify.
Go on, sir. I think no one has doubts.
Okay, nobody is responding. Okay, right. See, one more thing. Here, in electrical engineering, the electromagnetic induction, flow of direction of the current and the movement of a piece in the solenoid, all these things are represented by Fleming's left hand rule. And for mechanical engineering, we generally have to understand the Fleming's right hand rule. Here, once you stretch the thumb, forefinger and the middle finger at right angles to each other, the thumb represents positive x-axis, the tip of the thumb. And the tip of the forefinger represents y-axis. And the tip of the middle finger represents z-axis. Here, the z-axis will be the spindle axis for any machine. Okay? Z-axis is always the spindle axis, and the point of intersection of the spindle face and Z-axis or spindle axis is called datum point. Just understand what I am telling you. If you understand whatever I am telling you at this stage clearly, and you will not forget anything, and you can easily understand the succeeding portions of our course. Otherwise, it will be difficult for you. So, the point of intersection of spindle face and the Z-axis or spindle axis is called datum point. And the monitor on these CNC machines always displays X value, Y value, and Z value. That means coordinate values of datum point only. Just remember that. Okay? So, can I assume that everybody who have been attending this have understood what I have told you now? Or else, just raise your doubts immediately and I shall clarify.
Sir, can you just repeat this Fleming's right-hand rule, sir?
Right.
About that datum point.
Just, మీరు ఏం చేస్తారంటే రైట్ హ్యాండ్ మూడు వేళ్ళని బటన్ వేలు చూపుడు వేలు మధ్య వేలు మూడు రైట్ యాంగిల్లో పెట్టండి.
ఎస్ సార్.
రైట్ యాంగిల్స్ లో ఉండాలి వితౌట్ ఎనీ బ్యాండ్.
ఎస్ సార్.
దెన్ ది థంబ్ బటన్ వేలు ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ ని చూపిస్తుంది.
ఓకే సార్.
చూపుడు వేలు వై యాక్సిస్. గోర్ అండ్ మిడిల్ ఫింగర్ రిప్రజెంట్స్ జెడ్ యాక్సిస్.
ఎస్ సార్.
ఇన్ దట్ హియర్ ఈ టిప్ ఆఫ్ ది మిడిల్ ఫింగర్ మస్ట్ బి ఎట్ ది మౌత్ ఆఫ్ ది స్పిండిల్. అర్థమైందా?
Yes sir, yes sir. Sir, can you just tell in English, sir, because I'm from Karnataka.
Sure. See, yes. The middle finger must be always kept such that it enters into the spindle of the machine. Okay?
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Then X-axis, Y-axis and Z-axis are on directly to you. Okay?
Yes sir. Yes sir. Yes sir.
Good. Another thing is, here, whether if you give a command after learning the program, if you give a command to move X-axis or Y-axis, then what happens? Either the table will move or the column will move. Just don't bother about that. Okay. You always assume that you are viewing, you are seeing from the spindle. That means your eye is in the mouth of the spindle.
Yes, sir. Like,
no, not that axis. Your eye is in the mouth of the spindle.
Yes, sir.
Then only the directions of the movements assumed by you will be correct. Otherwise, you will be getting confused.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right.
Got it.
Yeah. Next slide. Here, I have summarized the axis and they have written IJK in addition to this. Just to go through this. Summarizing the above, we can write as follows. Linear axis of...
Hello?
Yes.
Hello, sir.
Chapter.
Someone in the message is asking what is mean by extension.
Extension means there will be telescopic arrangements in the machine. Because suppose if you have a 6 meters stroke in Z-axis, you cannot simply move the entire column by 6 meters. But there will be, the manufacturers will provide 4 meters stroke in the column, and the remaining 2 meters will be provided in to bring forward the spindle only from the column. That means there will be a movement of 4 meters by the column and 2 meters by the spindle. So totally 6 meters movement has been executed. 6 meters movement can be executed in Z-axis. That is the way. Okay. After completing the class, the last 10 minutes I shall allot for clarifying the doubts, and I shall minimize the screen and come to the messages. Then I shall clarify by name, okay? Name of the participants. So right now, let us go through the slide now. So linear axis are X and U, Y and V, Z and W. And the rotary axis are A axis, which rotates about X axis, B axis, which rotates about Y axis, and C axis, which rotates about Z axis. And the third column, I, J, and K. These three are called circular interpolation parameters. These three parameters are used for writing a program or for circular arcs. And this I, J, K will decide the direction of the arc, circular arc, with respect to its center point and with respect to its previous geometrical segment. Okay? I shall explain you when explaining about G02 and G03 meant for circular interpolation. So here, as I have told you already, the coordinate values of datum point are always all displayed on the monitor. Okay? So can I assume that everybody have understood this particular slide? Or else just raise your doubts. If anybody had any doubts, please ask immediately. Okay, we'll go to the next slide. See, in Cartesian coordinate system, we will be having three values, X, Y, and Z. And these are all the measurements taken with reference to the origin of the graphical representation, that is O, 0, 0, 0. Okay? As we concentrate doing part programs on XY plane or any plane parallel to XY plane, the position of the coordinate will be given by X and Y, and the depth will be represented by the Z. Okay? And again, as we are considering horizontal machining centers, that means machining centers which have horizontal spindle. That's all. For vertical machining centers, the spindle will be vertical and work will be mounted on the vertebrae. Okay. Still, the XY plane and the depth is represented by Z. Both are same. Except that horizontal spindle and vertical spindle will be there in horizontal and vertical machining centers. So, the default coordinate system in any machine, in any CNC machining center, will be Cartesian coordinate system. But sometimes we will be needing polar coordinate system also for expressing the coordinates of various points. And in polar coordinate system, we will be representing the coordinates by length of the line and angle with respect to the positive x-axis. And the angle would have to be measured only in counterclockwise direction, or as people say, anti-clockwise direction. So if you measure the angle between a line and the positive x-axis in clockwise direction, it becomes negative. That means we can express a line which is in third quadrant and making an angle of 300 degrees with respect to positive x-axis as 100 mm. Let us say that the length of the line is 100 mm. So 100 angle 300. Or 100 angle minus 60. Because a line which makes 300 degrees with respect to positive x-axis in counterclockwise direction will be making an angle 60 degrees in clockwise direction. So 100 angle minus 60 or 100 angle 300. Both are same. But in CNC machines, you would have to give the coordinates in positive values only. Of course, some of the machines will accept minus angle also, but that depends on the parameters fed by the PLC programmer there. Okay? Every CNC machine will have one programmable logic control. In that, there will be around 30,000 to 40,000 parameters which specify every basic thing and calibrate the machine to the parameters given by the PLC programmer. If such things, if at all anybody skips a particular function, you will not be having a full-fledged action of a CNC machining center. Okay? In a way, a CNC machining center is analogous to a 2 or 3 months baby for him, for which we would have to feed everything. We have to teach him how to speak. We have to teach him what to do and what not to do. So we will be just giving all the necessary data to the missing center and do the PART program in a correct way, and then only you can expect good results out of it. Otherwise, everything goes wrong. And if at all any CNC missing center does not give any good result, it is merely due to the human errors, but not the fault of any machine. Okay? So, coming back to polar coordinate systems, you just go through this slide here. The point, any point, is located by its distance or radius r to the point of origin. That means, let us say 1 minute. Suppose here this is origin and this is the end point of the line. Here the length of the line is r, and the angle made by beta, let it be beta. Here it has given XOP as alpha. So let us say that it is Q, and XOQ will be beta. Okay? So you will be expressing the coordinates in terms of length of the line and angle of the line made from positive x-axis. Okay? So I shall show you how to express polar coordinates in another slide that has been already prepared by me. I shall show you that. So let us just switch over to Cartesian coordinate system and go through the figure given in here. In this, I have drawn straight lines OA, AB, BC, CD, DG, and EF. Here, OA makes an angle of 60 degrees with the positive x-axis, and x and y coordinates are 100, and that should be 200 or 250. And then, 1 minute, OA, 173.2, okay? 173, OA, the coordinate values of A is 100, 173.2, and coordinate values of B, 400, 173.2, coordinate values of C, 400, 290, and similarly, the coordinate values of C, D, E, F can be just deduced from the graphical representation given here. And here you have to note down that all these coordinates have been expressed with reference to origin O. Okay? So whatever coordinates we express with reference to the origin are called absolute coordinates. Okay? That means, what do you mean by absolute coordinates? Absolute coordinates are the values, x and y values of various points expressed with reference to origin. That's all. Okay? And I have summarized all these values in the next slide. If you have a pen and a rough book, you just note down this graph so that if we go to the next slide, that will be visible and you cannot see this. And you can just tally what are the values given in the graph and how they are represented in a tabular form. That will be easy for us. Okay? Just copy down this particular slide. Only graphical representation and the values of A, B, C, D, E, F as shown here. Okay. See, here the coordinates of the points are expressed in Cartesian and polar systems for the above figure. That means for the figure that I have shown. See, here the columns, various columns represent serial number, point, name of the point, x coordinate and y coordinate. In the second set, under polar form, serial number, length of the line by OA, OA, B, B, C, like that. And the length of the line is written here, and the angle is shown in the last column of the table. So first, let us consider only Cartesian form. In this, what are the coordinates of O? It is 0, 0. So X0, Y0. And again, coming to the second row, the coordinate values of A are shown as X value is 100 and Y value is 173.2. So here X value is 100 and Y value, I have just edited, it is not appearing here, I shall correct it. It is 173.2 here. Okay. Similarly, the coordinate values of B are 400 and 173.2. You go 400 and 173.2. Similarly, the coordinate values of C are 400 and 290. You go 400 and 290. Okay. Similarly, the coordinate values of D are 700 and 290. 700, 290. Okay. And coordinate values of point E are 755. 700 here and 115. It is 115. That is mistyped by me. I just get it corrected. So the last point F, it is 640 and 55. 640 and 55. In the sixth row, it is 115. Yes, the mistyping has taken place. I shall correct it. So just take a note of it and copy down the values in a rough paper so that you can tally that. So if you express all these coordinates with reference to origin of the graph, then these are called absolute coordinates. Suppose if you express the X value and Y value with reference to the previous point, then it is called relative coordinate system. I shall tell you that. Absolute coordinate system refers to the origin, whereas relative coordinate system refers to the expressing a value with reference to the previous point. And in our diagram, if we start expressing the coordinates in polar coordinate system, then the value of OA is here. OA length is 200 mm and angle is 60 degrees. See here, this is the along x-axis it is 100, along y-axis it is 173.2. Okay, so using Pythagoras theorem, if you calculate the length OA, it is 200. Okay, so OA is 200 and angle is 60. So in polar coordinate system, X represents the length of the line and Y represents the angle. So 200 angle 60. That is the way in which we express the dimensions of lines in terms of length of the line and angle of the line. So coming here, AB. AB is parallel to X-axis. So the angle between AB and X-axis, positive X-axis, is 0 degrees. But the length of the line AB is 400 minus 100. It is 300. So 300 angle 0. 300 angle 0. Here it is AB. Okay. And BC. BC, the line is drawn from B to C. That means vertically upwards in the direction of 90 degrees. So the angle of BC with respect to positive x-axis is 90 degrees, and the length of the line is 290 minus 173.2. Okay, that comes over to 116.8. Here, BC 116.8, angle 90 degrees. Okay, from C, again, the D is towards positive x-axis. It is in the direction of positive x-axis. That means the angle of CD is 0 degrees because it is parallel to, yes? Yes, please. Hello?
Please take carry on, sir.
All right. So CD is parallel to positive x-axis. I am hearing somebody's voice, sir.
Gayatri, please make your mic mute, na? Hello, Gayatri? Do you have any doubts, Gayatri?
If she had any doubt, let her ask.
Just a minute, sir. Gayatri, do you have any doubt?
Okay, after explaining this particular two systems of coordinates, I shall wait for another 10 minutes and clarify.
Yeah, Gayatri, please make your video off. Thank you.
Okay. So CD is parallel to positive x-axis, and the angle between CD and x-axis is OX. Angle between CD and OX is 0 degrees. And length of the CD, length of the line CD is 700 minus 400. That is 300. So 300 angle 0 is its R coordinates. CD 300 mm length and angle is 0 degrees. Next comes DE. See, the line is traveling in the direction of minus y axis. That means the line is, the start point of the line is D and the end point of the line is E. And DE is parallel to minus y-axis or y-axis, and its angle will be 270 degrees from positive x-axis. So the length of the line is 290 minus 115. That comes out to 175. So 175 and 270 degrees are the coordinates of DE in polar coordinate system. Okay. And I have, just you see here, DE, 175 mm length and angle is 270. Okay. Next comes EF. Here, for EF, I have given 45 degrees angle. I have specified 45 degrees angle. And in x-axis, it is 700 minus 640. That comes out to 60. Similarly, in y-axis, it is 115 minus 55. That is also 60. As both the x value and the y, x component and y component are equal, the angle of the line EF is 45 degrees with reference to minus x axis. Okay. So the angle of EF with reference to positive x axis is 180 plus 45, 225 degrees. Because the end point of the line is F and the start point is E, and it lies in third quadrant. So length of the line will be 60 root 2. That means 84.84. Okay. So the coordinates of EF are 84.84 and angle 225 degrees. So all of you are requested to understand what are the things that I have explained today. Go through the slides, as these will be available with you now. And if you have any doubts, you can just ask me now or after going through these topics again tomorrow also you can ask. Okay. So I shall minimize the screen and go to the messages so that somebody will be sending us messages instead of directly asking in the microphone. Okay, Madhu?
Yes, sir. Please proceed.
All right.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, you told that polar coordinate system, we should take it in an anti-clockwise direction.
Yes.
Yes.
But when you took this example, you took in clockwise direction, sir.
Where?
The diagram you shown just now.
No. See, I have been taking 0 degrees will be lying on positive x-axis.
Okay.
From there to minus x-axis, it is 180.
Yes, sir.
and from 180 degrees, the angle has been shown as 45 degrees for EF.
Yes, sir.
So 180 plus 45 is 225.
Yes, sir.
And the all these angles, angular dimensions have been taken from x-axis in counterclockwise direction only.
Okay, sir.
See, one more thing.
Yes, sir.
You just assume that x-axis and y-axis both are shifted to the start point of every line. Okay.
Okay. Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
All right. Okay. Previously, one participant by name Gayatri has been putting on the mic. Does she have any doubt?
No, no, sir. Vijayasagar, you will be getting this flight by, I hope by 8:30 today.
Junaid Muhammad, he has been asking for explanation of data point. See, for any machine, the spindle axis is always Z axis. Okay? Z axis will be the spindle axis. And there will be one face for every spindle. So the point of intersection of spindle face and Z axis is called a datum point. And in any CNC machine, the coordinates will be expressed on the monitor. Those coordinates are pertained to datum point only and nothing else. That's all. Okay? And Suryaneni Venu, you have been asking about Cartesian coordinate means. See, the graphs that you are more familiar with in your studies, X value, Y value, Z value, all these coordinates are a part of Cartesian coordinate system. Okay? Cartesian coordinates are nothing but expressing the position of a point or a line in terms of X, Y, and Z values. That's all. And nothing else. Okay? And any more doubts? Mr. Sagar, you have been asking me to repeat the previous slide. Which slide is that? Because I have already minimized the slides. As these slides will be available to you, you just go through them. If you have any doubt, tomorrow again we will be conducting the class. No, just I shall clarify that. Okay? Mr. Venu, you have been asking about extension. Extension means, see, in heavy machines, the spindles will be of around half a meter in diameter. In that case, the spindle head will be around 1 meter or 1.5 meters, and the column will be 4 meters and 5 meters like that. So you cannot move such heavy columns throughout the stroke provided in the machine. So some part of the stroke is provided by the movement of the heavy column, and the remaining part by the movement in the spindle. So, and these two movements will be on the same axis. Let us assume that it is on x-axis. Then some part of the movement will be done by the table, and the remaining part by the column in the same direction of the table. In that case, we call the movement as X and U, X-axis and U-axis. If the movements are made in Y-axis, then Y-axis and U-axis, V-axis. If the movements are done along Z-axis and the extension is provided parallel to Z-axis, then it is Z-axis and W-axis. X, Y, Z, U, V, W. That's all. You can just go through the live videos provided in YouTube. simply type CNC machining centers and you will get several thousands of videos. Okay, or else if anybody of you are working in any industry, it will be very easy for you to understand. Mr. Vijayasagar, these slides will be sent to your IDs and Madhukar sir will take care of it. Don't worry about that. Sir, can you explain from the point? Mr. Vadyarani Chiluka, you have been asking me to explain the point. Which point? D, yeah? C, 1 minute. You just go back to the slide. And before expressing the angle of any line, you just assume that the origin is placed on the start point of the line. Yes? Assume that origin is shifted to the start point of the line and start measuring the angle of the line with respect to positive x-axis. Automatically, you will get the answer for that. Okay? Still, if you have the doubt, just raise the doubt tomorrow evening. I shall clarify. Pradeep Sunkari, why should we use only Z-axis as spindle axis? See, there are certain machines in which multiple spindles are provided, like a spindle on X-axis, a spindle on Y-axis, and a spindle on Z-axis. Like that, but the default axis for Z-axis is Z-axis. The default axis for spindles is Z-axis, and there are certain rules laid by the Bureau of Indian Standards as well as ISO 9000 system, that is International Standards Organization. And similarly, even for designing gears, spindles, diameters of various components, for everything whichever you design, there are certain rules. We have to simply tally those rules and design the machine as per that only. Otherwise, you will not be getting the license or you will not be getting the authorization to manufacture the machine. So the spindle axis must be Z-axis. And this particular rule has been laid out by ISO 9000 organization as well as Bureau of Indian Standards also. Or wherever you go, in whichever country you go, it is the same. Okay? And any more? YouTube link. Mr. Vineet, spindle is generally not represented by X and Y axis or U and V axis. It is represented by Z and W axis. Z axis represents the movement of the entire column towards the workpiece or away from the workpiece. Whereas W axis represents the spindle, movement of spindle out of the spindle head or backwards into the spindle head. Okay. Any more? Any more doubts? If you have any doubt, just put on your microphone so that I can hear you directly. It will be comfortable to us both. Okay?
Yes, sir. I think we can end for the day. Yeah, everyone, you will be please check your WhatsApp and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the updates of the class uploads regularly. Every class will be uploaded on the next day by 12 p.m. I hope the class was good for today. If you have any suggestions, any feedback, or any incremental techniques which you want to specify, you are free to mention us in the to my personal chat, which will be found in the in a group chat, the regular message. So you can get back to me. Okay. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for joining us in this course. Sir, we can end up for the day, sir.
Okay. Thank you very much. Good night to everybody.
Thank you, sir.